Also es zeichnet auf.
Na, es ist schön, wenn da mal ein bisschen was los ist. Latschen könnt ihr so.
Too far away.
Should I give you? Can't you place it on the ground?
I just moved.
Wait. I might be small.
Oh, is it okay that I move?
Schönen guten Abend! Darf ich kurz um Ihre Aufmerksamkeit bitten? Ich heiße Sie herzlich willkommen zum Circuit 3 von Songs and Whispers. Ich sehe einige bekannte Gesichter, alle die neu sind. Schön, dass ihr gekommen seid. Wir haben heute Abend ein Konzert, das ist folgendermaßen aufgebaut. 45 Minuten wird der Junge Herr hier spielen, dann machen wir eine kurze Pause, dann gibt es nochmal 45 Minuten und dann können wir uns miteinander unterhalten. Ich werde im Laufe dieses Konzerts zweimal, beziehungsweise in jedem Block einmal mit dem Hut rumgehen. Es gibt heute Abend keinen Eintritt, aber es wäre schön, wenn ein bisschen Kleingeld in den Hut landet. Das geht direkt an Brett. Das war's eigentlich schon. Sie haben hier einen Flyer auf Ihrem Stuhl vielleicht gefunden. Da sind alle anderen Termine. Wir veranstalten Touren. Die sind immer dreiwöchig. Jeden Monat eine neue Tour mit zwei neuen Artists. Können Sie gerne mal reingucken. Es gibt das große Abschlusskonzert immer am Ende des Monats. Das ist im Club Moments. Diesmal am 2.4. Und dann würde ich sagen, das ist Brett aus den USA. Künstlername This Frontier Heroes. Und er möchte den Ladies verlauten lassen, er ist Single und hat nichts gegen ein deutsches Visum.
Viel Spaß.
Did he tell you what I, the joke? Thank you so much for coming, I really appreciate it. I'm having a great time, I've been in Germany for 1 week now, so.
Winter is a very nice time here.
Well, it's gotten better today. Well, back in New York, they got 1 foot of snow right now, so this is better.
Where are you from?
I'm from New York originally, but I just moved to Nashville, Tennessee, so.
Okay.
They got snow, too. I'm going to start off tonight with a Woody Guthrie song. In the world's mighty gallery of pictures, there are scenes that are painted from life. Scenes of youth and of beauty, and scenes of hardship and strife. Scenes of wealth and of plenty, old age and a blushing young bride. There on the wall stood the saddest of all. That's a picture from my southern side. A picture from life's other side. Somebody had fell by the way. When the light's gone out with the tide, though we might have been happy someday. A poor old woman alone, longing and waiting at home. Longing to hear from a loved one so dear. That's a picture from life's other side. Now the first scene is of two brothers. Their paths are differently led. One lived in luxury and riches, while the other one begged for his bread. One night they met on the highway. Your money or your life, so he cried. There with his knife, took his own brother's life. That's a picture from life's other side. A picture from life's other side. Somebody had fell by the way. When the lights gone out with the tide, though we might have been happy someday. A poor old woman alone, watching and waiting alone, longing to hear from a loved one so dear. That's a picture from life's other side. Now the last scene is of two women, a broken-hearted woman and babe. How the harbor lights shine and shiver for an outcast that no one could save. For once she was a true woman, someone's darling and babe. God help her, she leaps, for there's no one to weep. That's a picture from life's other side. Picture from life's other side. Somebody had fell by the way. When the light's gone out at the tide, though we might have been happy someday. A poor old woman alone, watching and waiting alone, longing to hear from a loved one so dear. That's a picture from life's other side. Alright, here's a song I wrote one day. I was out in Beverly Hills, California, where all the fancy people live. And I was on tour. I just played a show. I was staying at my friend's house. I woke up and I saw that George Clooney had just gotten arrested. And I'm like, oh no, George, what have you done now? And turns out he was protesting about the conditions in the Sudan. And I was like, wow, man. What am I doing with my life? George Clooney's going out there, putting his life on the line, going to jail for what he believes in. So I wrote a song about him. It's called George Clooney. Well, woke up so sad and alone. Another waste. Night on the sunset strip. You know that these lights don't mean nothing, except all of the water I should have sipped. Well, I'm waiting now for some inspiration, something that'll make me move. Everything's coming at me all at once, and there's so much that I could never prove. Well, even George Clooney gets lonely. Maybe he just goes to sleep alone, sitting in a jail or in a taxi. Well, how I hate to hear you cry and moan. The ghosts of entertainers are all around me. This is where you go to try and buy all your silly dreams and hopeless lies. The world of man is sick and needs to cry. Well, even George Clooney gets lonely. Read about it on CNN. Married or divorced, what's the difference? A whole lot of nothing, of course. You're never gonna get ahead in this town. Just hope to cruise and bide your time. A once in a million gets lucky. The rest of us just suffer through and try. Well, I don't wanna hurt you, curse you. I don't want you to stop having fun. But all the money in the world can undo all the stuff that I still haven't done. Well, even George Clooney gets on. And Angelina Jolie, well, they can't hide from all their beauties. Or turn away when they don't think it's fair.
So we had a very traumatic election in the United States last year, and it didn't go the way that it was supposed to. But, you know, no matter what happens, remember that Trump lost by 3 million votes, but somehow he's still the president. So he's the biggest loser of all time. But anyway, back in 2012, everybody thought the world was going to end because of the Mayan calendar. Do you remember this whole thing?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was like, there was some, you know, something was going to happen and the world was going to end. But you know what? It didn't. So people always think the world is going to end. The world's going to end. We don't know. Humans don't know when the world is going to end. So I wrote this song as a... for all the people who thought the world was gonna end.
I don't believe in certainty, and I don't like routine. But we could be the bestest friends that we could ever be. But you don't believe in miracles unless I tell the lie. So what good is it honestly if we say goodbye? So lose yourself, get some help, cause 2012's like nothing else. Lose yourself in the mystery, lose yourself in reality. Hang on to your sanity, grab yourself the best girl you can. Now don't get angry or confused, cause a revolution is coasting on fumes. Our momentum take us in when the expectation is just too hard to bear. So lose yourself, get some help, cause 2012's like nothing else. Lose yourself in your liberty, see those patterns too, and I'm just as scared as you. And if the myths should take us down. Well, I just hope that we could hang around. So lose yourself, get some help, cause 2012's like nothing else. Lose yourself in the mystery. Lose yourself in philosophy. Hang on to the harmony. Grab yourself the best girl you can. Drinking as much as possible when I'm at home too. So, I hear Bremerhaven has got a museum for emigration, and in New York we have a museum for immigration because all the people came to New York, and so last year, like, you know, Donald Trump started talking about all the immigration, illegal immigrants, blah blah blah, blah, all that negativity, and my family came to America from Italy and about 100 years ago. And at that time, Italians were scapegoated in America. They were called criminals and rapists and thieves and all the same thing that Trump is saying about Mexican people now. So I was deeply offended because I was like, I knew the history of America, how they do this every 50, whenever they just scapegoat some new group of people. And it's crazy, even now when you're Italian, you know, they're like, everybody says, oh, are you in the mafia and stuff? They say it to me now. And it's kind of like, are you an idiot? But anyway, so I was like, well, what's the one thing that I can do to help? And I was like, remind people of our history and then say it with a loving message. So I wrote a song, it's called I Love Immigration. And it's a true story of my family. When my great-grandpa was just 13, he came all the way from Italy, sailing on a ship to the land of hope and freedom. Well, he wanted to escape poverty. Well, here's a little history. America should have been named Vespucci. Well, I love immigration, I love immigration. It's the force that brought me to this nation. So use your imagination. It's a journey, not a destination. I say this now without any hesitation. Well, a few years later, he had to go back because the powers that be were on the attack. And he swore us all an oath of loyalty. To be part of this great citizenry, he had to prove his bravery, and he got a purple heart, and now we have our freedom. Well, I love immigration, I love immigration, it's the force that brought me to this nation. So use your imagination, it's a journey, not a destination, put your ignorance in hibernation. Now if you're one for irony, he had to stop speaking openly and change his name because we both called us Nanny. Well, he worked real hard in a factory, started my family, and because of people like us, you've got spaghetti. Well, I love immigration, I love immigration. It's the force that brought me to this nation. It's not an investigation, not a reason for interrogation. So forget your wall and end this exploitation. Well, I never met an immigrant that I didn't like. We just came here for a better life. Because our restaurants need diversity. Heck, I was just looking at my DNA. I'm pretty much a mutt in every way. So I hate hate because I can't hate myself. Now, unless you're Native American, I got some good information. You probably better stop complaining. Because for every incarceration, you could have had some education. So forget your wall and end this exploitation. Well, I love immigration. I love immigration. It's the force that brought me to this nation. So use your imagination. It's a journey, not a destination. I say this now without any hesitation.
I heard that Angela Merkel and Trump were supposed to meet this week sometime. And I think what Angela Merkel should do is take that big fat idiot over to the Berlin Wall Museum in Berlin and teach him about what humanity is. Because I am just so disappointed in my country right now. We're better than this, and we're gonna survive it, and we're gonna be better. So. I was just watching a video today of Mexican families who go up to a wall right just south of San Diego, California, and they have to look at their family members through a fence, and they can't be together. And I this is not right, and I don't stand for it. All right, anyway, back to, let's go on to better subjects. So I've been living in Florida for the last few years. How many of you have been to Key West, Florida? It's a beautiful island all the way at the end. It's like 4 hours south of Miami, so it's very, very, very far. There's a lot of interesting history there. Ernest Hemingway lived there, and so I wrote a song about it. It's called Key West. Well, she's as pretty, pretty as a lioness, and like a lion, I tamed her myself. I walked right up and I said, hey, you'll never guess. It's just a beautiful sunset, as south as we can get. Well, I never had a home that I could call my own. So I guess I'm gonna have to roam. Build a nest. Tonight will be Key West. Well, she laughed at first, and so I smiled back. Then I asked her, what do you think about that? You know, we're closer to Cuba than the U.S., where people make all their money from shipwreck. Well, there used to be a train
all the way from Maine. And then a hurricane wiped it out. It's never been the same. Well, Hemingway really loved his cat. Polydactyl, now you try saying that. He put him in his will, then blew his brains right out. Now the old man in the sea is sailing with Hunter S. Well, I'm not here for myself. I really just wanna help to try and be just blessed. You and me should start a really good business. Well, you won't have to worry, 'cause here it never frosts. Where we can sleep outside under the Spanish moss. That's when I started to detect a subtle pause. And in my mind, all I heard was a thought. Well, why don't we invest in all the world's homeless and put our ills to rest? I bet that'd be the best thing we could do. Hitchhike to Key West.
Lived in Florida, and they're near St. Augustine, which is one of the oldest cities in America. It was founded by the Spanish in around 1500, and there's an old Spanish fortress there. So if you ever go to Florida, you should actually go check out St. Augustine. It's really neat. And there's a guy named Stetson Kennedy who used to live there, and he was friends with Woody Guthrie. Stetson Kennedy actually infiltrated the Ku Klux Klan back in the 50s and exposed them for the racist murderers and terrorists that they were. And actually had to leave the country and was friends, moved to Paris, and Jean-Paul Sartre would publish all of his books. And anyway, Woody Guthrie used to come to Florida and he would write all these songs at Stetson's house while Stetson was in France. Sorry, is that bothering? You can't hear me right now, can you? All right, I'll tell the story again after. Whoa. Big, powerful scooter. Yeah, we'll wait. We got time, right?
So is your flat empty at the moment in Florida?
No. I got rid of it.
Okay.
But I moved to Nashville. So my flat in Nashville is empty. But, you know, that's not a big deal. I can still just stay here if I want to. If I can get a job. Hey, take your time, guys.
Thank you.
somewhere in the far. Blackberries, hey, all out. Woody Guthrie used to go to Stetson's house while he was in France. He had to leave America for over 10 years because the KKK wanted to kill him. And he wrote all these songs there. And so I was able to, when Stetson died, which was only about 5 years ago, they turned his house into a museum. And the house next door now is a songwriter residency, where songwriters can go for 2 weeks and write songs in the same place that Woody Guthrie wrote all these songs. So here's one of the songs that I wrote while I was there. It's called Free Market Music. And it's all about what it's like to be a musician. And it's also like, a lot of times people like, whenever you're like, say something political in music, people always criticize you. Even if they agree with you. Just because, like, who are you to say blah, blah, blah? Like, I actually had somebody say, oh, you're off in Germany playing music. And I was like, so what's your point? Like, what's your point? So does that mean my political opinions don't matter because I'm successful in, like, playing for tips in Germany? I mean, there's just so much negativity in the world right now. It's just unreal. So we gotta try to stay positive and, you know, anyway. Being a musician's not easy. Well, I've got to prove myself every single day in a different town across the USA. Now once in a while I might get something free, but karma's too slow when the banks are counting on me. Now the traders on Wall Street, they have a divine plan. It's good for their investors, ain't always good for man. So just pay the workers for the labor of our hands. So now I'm speaking up for all of our demands. Free market music, you better not abuse it, cause some poor musicians suffering. Technology is great, but it ain't always good, so pay musicians what you should. Well, I've heard it all before from people in the know. Just sell a bunch of t-shirts or tickets to a show. Now if you had to live upon that income stream, I know you'd buy that tune if you know what I mean. Cause I know what it's like to be homeless. I know what it's like to be poor. And if you want a world filled with music, then pay musicians what we're working for. Pay musicians what we're working for. Free market music, you better not abuse it. Some poor musicians suffering. Well, gratitude is great, but it won't buy me food. So throw some dough in my boot. Now I believe in stuff like democracy, and maybe someday music can be free. But if we can't solve all this inequality and just give the people what we need, 'cause if I can't buy a home or pay my student loan, well, if you want a healthy economy, then pay me something so that I can breathe. Pay me something so that I can breathe. Free market music, you better not abuse it. Some poor musicians suffering. Technology is great, but it ain't always good. So pay the people what you should.
Frustrating. Do you guys have minimum wage in Germany?
Yeah.
Well, what is it?
$8.50.
Okay, so you're not that much better than us. In America, it's like $7.50. So, but we don't have health care, and we don't like, there's a lot of other things too that poor people are like, there's like, this is one of the craziest things, and we're going to find out this summer. So many immigrants, like, pick the vegetables that we eat, and they get paid minimum wage, right? And now Trump's kicking them all out, so who's going to... We're all going to starve to death, because there's nobody there to pick the food. Anyway, we'll see what happens. It's going to be a crash. If you have any money in the American stock market, I would get out now.
No.
Okay, you guys have your own stock market, right?
Yeah, we have.
Okay. That's a casino. This is called the Hoffman Casino, but that's the real casino. It's Wall Street. Did you ever see that Antonioni movie, L'Eclipse?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Have you seen it? Mm-hmm. There's that whole scene where the stockbrokers are going crazy. I love that movie, but it was like the stock market crashes, and it's like, it's just like a small little local Italian stock market, but it's kind of really funny. Yeah. I mean, that's what's going to happen on Wall Street next week. All right, well, here's another song from my new album. I do have CDs and records for sale, and I just got some stickers made today here, if anybody's interested. This song is called My Heart Tells Me Yes. It's all about how, you know, my mind tells me to do one thing and my heart tells me to do the other thing, and I get confused. So, but I end up making a mistake no matter what. My heart tells me yes, but my mind tells me no. It's so hard to decide which way to go. The wind won't stop, it's gonna blow. When my heart tells me yes, but my mind tells me no. Well, I wake up every morning feeling very high. By the time I go to bed, I'm still wondering why. Every moment is struggle and strife, when I should be out there living my life. Who am I to tell me that I'm wrong? Do I believe myself or the singer of this song? Manic depression comes and it's gone. Well, I hope it comes quick, 'cause it's lasting too long. Well, my heart wants to live, and my mind
is fed up to here with all this conflict and blame. Now I know the cause of suffering. It is one and the same. But my heart tells me yes, but my mind tells me no. It's so hard to decide which way to go. Wind won't stop, it's gonna blow. But my heart tells me yes, but my mind tells me no. Well, it's not so easy to know what to do with all these barriers that you got to go through. Obstacles feel pointless and arbitrary, but without them, I guess there'd be no misery. Well, my heart wants to live, and my mind is fed up to here with all this conflict and blame. Now I know the cause of suffering. It is one and the same. Well, I know I need help, but there's none to be had. But I will never quit, no matter how sad. I try to be stoic, but even the Buddha cried. Well, my heart is on that, 'cause my mind had to lie.
Every time I hear the thing flapping, it makes me think of a sail on a sailboat. And last summer, me and my friends were in New York for the summer, working on some houses, like fixing them up and stuff. And every Thursday, we'd go sailing afterwards and drink some beers and go sailing. And I made a video, like with a little camera, of us sailing on it. You can go to my YouTube channel on my Facebook page and see it. But it's for this song, it's called Don't Let the Dreamers Die, you know? And because that feeling that you get when you're sailing is like no other feeling that, you know, you have on land. Sometimes you follow your dreams and fail. Sometimes you make a mistake and end up in jail. Everyone knows someone that we love who needs our help when trouble comes. So don't let the dreamers die. Someday you wish that we were there. Give you hope when no one cares, and the courage when no one dares. I know that laughter saved our lives, but music saved my soul. So it's time for us to share, 'cause life is not a joke. Every problem that we face has a human cause or trait. Don't stick your head into the sand when you can lend a helping hand. So don't let the dreamers die. Someday you'll wish that we were there. To give you hope when no one cares, and
the courage when no one did. So many people drown in pain, some unknown and some in fame. When it's hard to just get through your day, you need to know that it's okay. So don't let the dreamers die. Someday you wish that we were there to give you hope when no one cares, and the courage when no one dares. So don't let the dreamers die. Someday you wish that we were there to give you hope when no one cares, and the courage when no one dares.
All right, I'm gonna take like a little 10-minute break and be right back, so go smoke, get another beer, go to the bathroom, whatever, and come right back. Thanks. I do have CDs and records for sale over here, so.
Sure. Okay. Hey.
Ich hoffe, wir sehen uns in 10 Minuten.
It's not a toy. Build more toys.